Welcome back to Dundee One TV, Travel Plus TV. Starting with this week, 6th of September 2021, all our other channels, Dundee One Travel Plus TV, Dundee One Auto Plus TV, Dundee One TV, we are starting airing on all those other channels in addition to Dundee One TV, the mother channel. So starting with today, we are continuing with our programs on those other channels. So just like you've been supporting us, then kindly subscribe to, for those who have subscribed to Dundee One TV but have not subscribed to the Dundee One Travel Plus TV, Dundee One Auto Plus TV, Dundee One Travel TV, let's all kindly subscribe to those channels too, so that they also become vibrant. Thank you so much. So our first program, as we are resuming Dundee One Travel Plus TV production, our first program we want to talk about is on the Pokwasi interchange that has been boggled. In the past few days, in the Ghana, the main Ghana media and on social media, what everybody is talking about is the boggling of the inaugurated Pokwasi interchange. That is so nice. Everybody is talking about it. Some weeks back, we heard of a woman who was doing trouble under the footbridge, under the interchange, which is ahead of Africa. They don't like anything good. Now, city authorities went and put that in order. As though that was not enough, people have stolen the street lights and have boggled the metal brackets that will prevent skidding vehicles from going off to their death. This is unheard of. If we are talking about Africa, if we are talking about Ghana, it is how to sell Ghana and get better dollars, not to sell bad news about Ghana. That is very bad. Unfortunately, that is what we have to talk about. So, newly installed crash barriers at the Pokwasi interchange boggled. Street light also removed. Now, barely 3 months after the inauguration of the Pokwasi interchange, some unscrupulous persons have stolen some of the newly installed galvanized crash barriers mounted at the interchange, thereby posing threat to road users. The stolen crash barriers at this Pokwasi interchange are valued at $3,500 and meant to protect vehicles from falling over from high embankment onto the main road for vehicles coming from Kwabena, cover a stretch of over 40 meters, about 40 meters. The total number of crash barriers stolen is 10. Each measuring 4 feet. That means like your feet, your foot, when you attach it like that, are four feet. As if that is not enough, 40 street lights on the street have also been damaged at the interchange. That is uncalled for. That is unacceptable. How can we as a nation progress with this kind of habit? From political corruption to stealing of street lights or damaging of street lights and stealing, how do you call it? The crash protection metals. They remove them. It is not good. Now, the stolen barriers were mounted on a higher embankment or cliff to prevent vehicles using a service road from the Victoria College area at the Pokwasi from falling over from a height of about 3 meters onto the road from Kwabena towards the main interchange. On the 4th of September, it was observed that although the bolts and nuts holding the barriers had been welded to prevent easy removal, the crash barriers had been moved nonetheless. Most motorists were using that portion of the road did not realize the danger ahead as they drove by. However, a few who might have observed that the street had become bare reduced their speed as they approached. Now, the fourth-year Pokos interchange on Accra and Sahun Pumasi Road is the first of its kind in West Africa. You see, something that expensive has been reduced to this and was inaugurated by President Nana Akufo-Addo on July 9, 2021. So it is not even long ago it was inaugurated. The project involved the construction of the 6.5. Kilometer Awoshi Pokwasi Road, an interchange at the intersection of the ACP junction to Awoshi to Nsawam Road, two footbridges, the widening of the Nsawam Road by 2 kilometers, drainage ways, the provision of street lights, and the construction of the 12 kilometer of town roads. Now, Mr. Kwabena Bempong, the engineer of the interchange, has said that since the incident has since been reported to the police, adding that this is very serious because if we do not put a stop to it, all the crash barriers that we have on the interchange will eventually be stolen. He said that an errand vehicle could fall from the access road near the residential facilities mostly used by private persons to the main road, hence the construction of the barriers. Mr. Bempong noted that the 40 street lights that were destroyed have since been replaced. Another problem, he said, was the use of jacks on the asphalt by vehicle owners who burst their tires whilst driving. He explained that placing the jack directly on the asphalt to replace burst tires could result in depression on the road, leading to final deterioration. He said there were others who did unauthorized U-turns on the road, resulting in a number of accidents. And he appealed to drivers to desist from that and use the designated routes for U-turns, although they might appear long. Meanwhile, the Amasaman Divisional Police Command has mounted a manhunt for the criminal persons behind the stealing of the barriers. That is Director General of the Public Affairs Directorate of the Ghana Police Service, Assistant Commissioner of Police, Mr. Kusufuri, said the police administration has instructed patrol teams to patrol the area, particularly during the night, when it was believed. When it was believed that criminal act was usually conducted. Now he explained that last Sunday, the engineers reported to the police that 10 bolt galvanized road barricades at the Victoria College area close to the Selfwell station end of the interchange had gone missing. Under a cover of darkness, ACP Ofori said following the report, some police members visited the scene and found that the bolts and nuts on the existing barriers had been welded. He said preliminary investigations indicated that the suspected thieves allegedly stole 4 street light connectors and subsequently plunged the area into darkness before carrying out their nefarious activities. In the case of the stolen connectors, he said they had been replaced and power had since been restored to the Pokwasi Kabana end of the interchange. He further said, when the police interviewed some of the residents and passersby, they all said they have no idea about the incident. You see, that is that thing about Ghana. People at an area don't show any interest in whatever is happening there. So maybe you are a foreigner and you have come to an area and you want even something. When you ask people around, they say they don't know anything about the area. So as Ghanaians, as Africans, let's show interest in whatever is happening at our area. You never know. It may save your own life or your relative's life. So that is one problem we must try and solve. It's a bad attitude. The General Secretary of the Christian Council of Ghana, Reverend Dr. Cyril Fayosi, also condemned the act, describing it as unpatriotic and unnationalistic. He did not understand why some persons would steal facilities that had been provided for ensuring safety on the road, adding that the money that would be used to replace the stolen items could have been used to provide other facilities elsewhere. So these are some of the things. How can a country progress with this kind of attitude? Stealing state properties, that will protect your own life, your relative's life. So the money that is used to replace these things can be used to further develop the country. And when we get that, we say politicians are corrupt. Yet we, the individuals in the society, are more corrupt with our evil attitude, our nefarious activities. So we talked about this one because it falls under the New One Travel Plus channel program mandate. Now, for those who are watching the New One Travel Plus TV for the first time and not subscribed, can you look at the lower right-hand corner of your screen? Click on the red subscribe button. Click on the bell, which is the notification button. So the next time I upload a video, one of the first YouTube automatically alert. And when you alert, can you watch the video from the beginning to the end? Remember to tell a friend to tell another person about the New One TV Travel Plus. The New One Travel Plus TV. Remember, the New One Travel Plus TV. More entertainment, more education. We are always there with you and for you. Till we see you in our next program on the New One Travel Plus TV. Bye-bye.